everyone, and welcome back to the barn. Today, I wanted to show you how to properly fit a halter for showmanship. So many times I see a really nice halter that just needs a few adjustments to take it to that next level. So let me show you how. Here you can see a properly adjusted halter. So let me point out a couple of areas that I always look out for. Please stand still. I know this is going to be hard for you. But number one is the throat area. See how the leather wraps around his cheekbone? That's something that originated from halter itself. You want to show off that cheekbone. And also, you don't want any slack. You want it pretty tight around their throat. Then the second part is the part that goes around the nose. I like to have it sit right in front of the cheek, and as well, that it needs to be tight. I can still get my fingers in here, but there really isn't any wiggle room at all. And then you can see that's how it should fit on their horse's head. As far as the chain is concerned, that is a very personal thing. Some people don't even want a chain on their horse, but it is mostly, how can I say it? The trend now is to have a chain on your horse. So however you adjust it, the length between the end of the chain and the halter is very personal, but my whole philosophy is that I don't want the chain dangling underneath of the chin. It's distracting, it makes noise, it doesn't look as polished. And then how you latch it on the other side, again, is very personal. I always try to latch it so that the actual hook is facing away from the horse so that it doesn't catch and then accidentally come off. But again, that's so personal, I don't want to tell you how to do that. So this is how I like it. I like it pretty short. Let me lift his head up here. Pretty short, you can see there's just a very small length here. The reason I do that is because I deal with a lot of babies and I don't want a lot of wiggle room, but then again, some people do. So that's generally what I'm looking for in a show halter. Some people find that when they get a halter, the reason it fits so loose is because they don't have enough holes, or it's too big, or it's too small. Well, unfortunately, you gotta test out some halters before you actually purchase the right one, because it is imperative that it fits properly. So again, make sure the crown piece is not too big, make sure the nose piece isn't too big, and in some situations, especially with the yearlings, you'll buy a halter and they'll outgrow it within 6 months. So then you can be a little bit more flexible, but it is generally, I suggest getting a yearling-sized halter if you're going to do a lot of it. However, don't be afraid to punch some holes too if it's off just a little bit. But I cannot stress enough how important it is to have a good fitting halter. It's the difference between having 90% and being 100% of the way there. So thank you again for watching. If you have any questions or comments, if you want me to expound on anything, feel free, leave a comment below. And always like, subscribe, and let me know that this is the content that you want to see. Have a good one.